Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Koffman, the co-founder, chief medical officer, and the executive vice president of the nonprofit CLL Society. And I'm going to be sharing some important research that's been presented over the last year. I'm going to now be talking about a paper presented at ASCO, the American Society of Clinical Oncology, in 2023. It was on fixed-duration ibrutinib and venetoclax for frontline treatment of chronic lymphocytic leukemia, CLL, small lymphocytic lymphoma. It was the four-year follow-up from the fixed-duration group. Let's start with the bottom line. Results of the CAPTIVATE study, which is what this large study was called, supports considering using ibrutinib venetoclax as an all-oral, once-daily, fixed-duration regimen for treatment-naive patients with CLL or SLL. With the follow-up now at 4 years, INV continues to provide deep and durable remissions with clinically meaningful progression-free survival and time off treatment, including in patients with high-risk features. Who performed the research and where it was presented? Dr. Paul Barr of the Wilmot Cancer Center in Rochester, New York, led an international group of researchers in presenting the results of more than 4 years of data at ASCO 2023 in Chicago, Illinois. Let's go over the background. CAPTIVATE was a very large, multi-centered phase two study of frontline ibrutinib and venetoclax in CLL, SLL. Follow-up from the fixed duration cohort was presented earlier and showed a 3-year progression-free survival of 88% and rates of greater than 80% in patients that had high-risk features. That was presented by Dr. Wirda at ASCO in 2022. This is a year later, updated versions of the fixed duration cohort with 4-year follow-up now. What were the methods and participants? Patients had to be 70 or younger with previously untreated chronic lymphocytic leukemia, small lymphocytic lymphoma, and then they received 3 cycles of ibrutinib and then 12 cycles of I plus V with the ramp up, the usual ramp up of venetoclax to reduce the risk of tumor lysis syndrome. What were the results? 159 patients were enrolled, including many with high risk features. For example, 56% had unmutated IGHV or deletion 17P or TP53 mutations. Median time on the study was 50 months. At the follow-up of 4 years, the best complete response rate was 58%. The overall response rate didn't change from the data at 3 years and was still a very impressive 96%. At 4 years, progression-free survival, the number of patients who were still alive and whose disease had not progressed was 79%. In other words, 8 out of 10 patients had not had any progression of the disease. And the really strong number of 98% of the patients were still alive. 4-year progression-free survivals was a little worse, as you'd expect, in the unmutated IGVH patients at 73%, or those with deletion 17P or TP53 mutations at 63%. But overall survival remained consistently high. 4-year progression-free survival by MRD, minimal residual disease status, 3 months after stopping treatment, so end of treatment plus 3 months, were significantly higher in patients who achieved undetectable or UMRD versus detectable UMRD, 90% versus 68%. No surprise there. The difference between those two groups had been minimal at 24%, 100% versus 91%. So the longer out, the more important the reaching undetectable MRD becomes. The 4-year rate of freedom from next treatment was 84%. And the median time to next treatment has not been reached. Second malignancies continued to be noted even off treatment, with one case of prostate cancer occurring during this year of follow-up. To date, 19 patients with progressive disease after completing the fixed duration of I plus V, in other words, they finished their therapy, either the fixed duration or the treat to reach MRD cohort, began retreatment with just ibrutinib. Responses in 17 patients, 17 of those 19, were available to report. There was one complete remission, 13 partial remissions, and one each a partial remission with a persistently high lymphocyte count, one stable disease, and only one patient with progressive disease. Median time on retreatment was 11 months with a range from 0 to 39 months. The most common adverse events that occurred in over 10% of patients were diarrhea, COVID-19 infections, and anemia. In addition, four patients have started I plus V retreatment to date. An additional four have started that were not reported on. So in conclusion, results of the CAPTIVATE study support I plus V as an all-oral, once-daily fixed-duration treatment for previously untreated patients with CLL or SLL. With the four-year follow-up, fixed-duration I plus V continues to provide deep and durable remissions, clinically meaningful progression-free survival, and long time off treatment, including in patients with high-risk disease features. There were really no significant unexpected side effects or adverse events, highlighting the benefits of this fixed-duration regime. Also, promising responses were observed upon retreatment, just using ibrutinib in patients who progressed. That said, while this combination has been improved in Canada and across Europe, the FDA has made it clear that it's unlikely to approve it in the USA, and approval is not being sought at this time. On the website, we provide a link to the actual ASCO article, Fixed Duration Ibrutinib plus Venetoclax for First-Line Treatment of Chronic Lymphocytic Leukemia, CLL, Small Lymphocytic Lymphoma, SLL, four-year follow-up from the fixed duration cohort of the Phase 2 CAPTIVATE trial. Thanks for listening. Stay strong. We are all in this together.